Hello. In this session, we'll be basically learning about the sorting technique, that is, importantly, the bubble sort. This is a sorting technique where we can assure that all the given set of data, whatever might be the size, is sorted completely. So let us see what is that particular technique, okay, using bubble sort. As the name itself says, it is the bubbles. When you have a data and you do iterative sorting one upon the other repeatedly, okay, it looks just like the bubble. We are doing the same work many number of times until the data are completely sorted. It is called bubble sort. Now let us see basically how does the bubble sort basically work. Okay, so here if you see I have taken the example of initial data, that is 5, 3, 8, 4 and 6. Okay, this is the input data that I want to sort. If I want to sort it in ascending order, my expected output might be 3, 4, 5, 6 and 8. Okay, now how do we proceed with sort? Let us see the first step here. What is first step doing? I am taking two numbers, first number and second number. We are comparing it. Okay, we are comparing it and then we are sorting those two numbers, wherein the rest three numbers, 8, 4 and 6 are untouched. Only the first two numbers are the target. Now 5 and 3 are compared. Okay, 3 is smaller, then I need to swap it. So I am swapping it. So next followed by second step. In second step, I will be comparing second and third number. So 3, 4 and 6 are untouched. 5 and 8 are dealt with. So 5 and 8 are already sorted. I need not swap them. So I am not swapping them. In third step, so I have 3, 5, 8, 6, 4, out of which 3, 5 and 6 I am not dealing with, only 8 and 4 are compared. So again 8 and 4 need to be swapped, so I am swapping it. Next step, 3, 5, 4 are untouched, 8 and 6 are compared, so they need to be swapped, so I am swapping it. So last step, if you see, in fifth step, even though I have completed comparing all numbers 1, 2, 2, 3, 3, 4, 4 and 5. Even though I have compared all the numbers, my last step, okay, is not sorted yet. Only thing what we can notice is the greater number has been brought to the last position. The larger number is in the last position. We have to take this as an input data and do this procedure again until the data are completely sorted. Okay, this is basically a bubble sort. So what is the basic key fundamentals in bubble sort? Just count how many data I had taken. I had taken 5 data. How many comparisons did I do? I did 4 comparisons. So if the data are 5, my comparisons will be 4. Similarly, for n number of data to generalize, I will have n minus 1 number of comparisons. So bubble sort means n minus 1 into n minus 1 times of comparison and sorting. Okay, hence the name bubble sort. So let me take one more example and illustrate. So this is my data, 12, 13, FA, 10, A and 14. I want to sort it in ascending or descending order depending on the question. Here I am taking an example of sorting it descending order. So I am sorting it here. So for this, my block size, that is the number of data, are 6. Okay. Now the count is 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5. I will need 5. Count. Okay. So understanding the program. Now we need to understand the program. The same way, we have the preprocessor directives. We have the counter 5. Now, they are not mentioning, okay, about a particular address. Again, the address selection is purely on the programmer. So, I am taking an external address 9000. Hence, I need DPTR to hold that 16-bit address. So, I am loading that 16-bit address to DPTR. So, we had seen in the example that I will need to restart the process in the after doing the first iterative of sorting. So, my DPTR will be repeatedly used. 9000 is repeatedly used in the program. We'll come back to this later. As I said, I will need n minus 1 into n minus 1 number of sorting. So, I'm moving R0 to R1 also. You know, you can't have two registers in the same instructions. That's why I'm loading R0 and R1 indirectly through accumulator. After that, first data is fetched to accumulator, copy to B. Now B is having the first data incremented, so it is pointing the second data, that is number 13, that is fetched to B. So now 12 is in B, 13 is in A. Right? Now you need to compare. In microcontroller 8051, we don't have a direct instruction to compare. So, I am using a simple arithmetic function, I am subtracting. To generalize, whenever I subtract a bigger number from a smaller number, I will need a borrow. Whenever I subtract a smaller number from a bigger number, I don't need a borrow. Borrow is here reflected in program status word of ET51 in terms of carry flag. So here, to generalize to ET51 concept architecture, whenever I am subtracting a greater number from a smaller number, I will generate a carry in a carry flag. Whenever I am subtracting a smaller number, okay, from a greater number, I do not generate a carry in a carry flag. So I am checking the carry flag condition. If there is no carry, that means the numbers are already sorted, I need not swap them. So, I will jump and I will start comparing the rest of the numbers. If there is a carry generated, then I need to swap. So, I am writing the number in B here. Okay. And whatever the number in A, I will be writing it here. So, I have sorted these numbers. So, from L2 to L2 here, it is first set of comparison. And here I will be comparing 5 times. So, 5 comparisons. Again, as I said, that should be taken as an input data and again do it. So, again, the first sorted, linear sorted data is again taken as an input and executed there. Hopefully, you people have understood the logic. Now, let us see how does this program work on key. So, I will just minimize. I will open Keel software. So, I will go to project, new project, give some name, select the hardware. These steps we had already discussed in detail, so I am not stressing much on it. I will write the program. This program is again understood, so I will save it as .asm file because it is an assembly language program. I am giving a name sort. Again, it is completely left to the programmer to select the name. So, I have saved the file as .asm. Normal procedure, I'll add the existing file here. So, my file type is ASM, I'll select. Now, from the list available, I'll select my sort file. You can see the sort is added. Now, let me save it again, just an assurance. I'll be translating. If everything is correct, I'll basically get 0 warnings and 0 errors. So I'll just translate. After translating, you can see I'm getting 0 warnings, 0 errors. That means the program is successfully translated to binary form. I'll build connecting it to the hardware characteristics. I'll basically click on debug. Obviously, the code is within the limits. So I want memory window, especially external memory. Whenever I use external memory, we know we are supposed to use X colon. The address used was 9000 in hexa. I'll just press enter. So I have opened the stack. Let's give the data. Some random datas I'll be giving. Some random hexadecimal numbers I have given. Let me run the program. So source and destinations are same here. There only I am doing the sorting. According to the count, I am supposed to give 6 numbers. If people can see, we have given the 6 numbers there. So I'll just run. You can see the number is sorted 2, 3, 33, BA, FA, and FF. So now this is in ascending order. If I want to execute in descending, so what should I do? I'll basically stop the debug. I'll just illustrate how to change the order. So I'll just change JNC to JC. I'll save, translate, build, and debug again. And 9000, I'll give the data. Some random data is given. I just run. You can see the order of sorting is changed. FF33, OF, OA, 06, and 01. So these is a sorting techniques. Hopefully you people have understood the sorting. So the same logic can be used to find out the largest number and smallest number in an array. The logic remains same. Instead of putting it, wrapping the numbers, we can take that resultant into the required register and take that register as a reference and start comparing with the other numbers. So the reference register will have the largest or smallest number. Okay. Thank you so much.